In this talk, I will present the results of approximation of Fabry-Pérot resonances in silver-quartz-silver structures. Spectral spatial filtration based on resonance structures has found many applications in sensing, optical image processing, spectroscopy, laser optics, and other fields. Estimation of the resonance field enhancement and characteristics of resonance line shapes in the spectral response attracts a considerable attention for design of resonance structures and determination of structural parameters.
Fabry-Pérot resonators are represented by two parallel mirrors separated by a dielectric medium at a certain distance from each other. The metal insulator metal planar structures can be considered as Fabry-Pérot resonators with absorbing mirrors. The excitation of the Fabry-Pérot modes by an incident wave results in the appearance of the resonance line shapes in the reflection and transmission spectra. The position and shape of the resonances depend on the angle of incidence of the light and its wavelengths, and can be estimated using rigorous electromagnetic theory with time-consuming data post-processing. Alternatively, the transmission spectra in Fabry-Pérot resonators with non-absorbing mirrors can be approximated by the sum of Lorentzian functions. However, the losses in the structure have a direct impact on the resonance line shape. We demonstrated recently that the approximation by Fano functions can be applied to spectral response and field in planar resonance structures, which support excitation of surface plasmon polariton modes and metal insulator interfaces, Fabry-Pérot modes, and interaction of the SPP modes and planar waveguide modes. Based on the Fano approximation of the resonance spectral response, the analytical expressions were obtained for the resonance line shape features, such as full width at half maximum, resonance height, and field enhancement as functions of structural parameters. We performed analysis of the field in MIM structures based on rigorous electromagnetic theory and obtained analytical expressions for estimation of the characteristics of resonance line shapes in spectra. In the case of close to normal incidence, the dependence of transmission coefficient T on the incidence angle for the MIM structure can be approximated by Lorentz formula as follows, where gamma FP is the effective refractive index of the Fabry-Pérot mode for a five-layer structure, can be estimated by this expression. K is the complex amplitude of the Fabry-Pérot mode for the three-layer structure with losses. Sigma is the coefficient of field synchronization in the dielectric layer of the resonator. Eta is the coefficient of the mode self-interaction as a result of multiple reflections in the metal layers. Based on the Lorentz representation, the full width at half maximum can be extracted as this expression, and height can be represented as this analytical expression. The resonance slope can be expressed as follows. Consider the planar MIM structure here. The structure is deposited on a substrate on glass K8. The stack of the structure consists of two metal layers of silver separated by a dielectric layer of quartz. A plane wave of the wavelength of 532 nanometers is incident in the air onto the structure and the incidence angle theta. To demonstrate the fitting of the resonance line shapes, we compare the exact transmission spectra obtained by transfer matrix method and spectra of the approximation based on the Lorentz function. Assume the structure with the thickness of silver layers of 65 nanometers. The angle transmittance spectra of the structure was obtained for the thicknesses of central layer of 3050 nanometers, 3060 nanometers, and 1052 nanometers, shown as solid lines. And we observe the resonances of the height of 0.8 and the width between 0.6 and 1.5 degrees. And the spectral resonance curves obtained by the exact electromagnetic theory are well approximated by Lorentz formula, this one, demonstrated as the dashed lines here. Consider the structure of the thickness of 3060 nanometers of quartz layer and perform estimation of the width and height and the slope of the resonance line shapes based on expressions obtained analytically as functions of the thicknesses of the inner and outer metal layers. In the calculations, the thicknesses of the silver layers varied from 1 to 100 nanometers with a step of 1 nanometer. The distribution of resonance widths is shown in the left figure. As can be seen, the maximum values of widths are achieved for minimum thicknesses, and the simultaneous increase in the thickness of both metal layers caused an exponential decrease in the widths. The dependence of resonance height on the thickness of metal layers, shown here on the central figure, and the maximum heights are observed for the minimum values of thicknesses of the metal layers, and both dependencies, the widths and the height, are symmetrical about the axis of equal thicknesses. The map of the resonance curve slope is shown on the right figure. In the region of maximum values of slope of around 0.1 degree in power of minus 1 is observed at the thicknesses of approximately 50 nanometers. And that result suggests that the resonance characteristics in MIM structures based on Fabry-Perot modes can be tuned in a wide range. To clarify the origin of the resonances shown in the previous figures, we calculated the electromagnetic field generated in the structure with the silver layer thicknesses of 65 nanometers and 3060 nanometers for the quartz. This polarized wave incidence using transfer matrix method, the distribution of electric field enhancement factor as function of position in the structure on that axis, and the angle of incidence as shown in the, on the right figure, as a color map of the ratio of the squared amplitudes of Y components of the electric field in the structure to the field of the incident wave. The air-silver interface corresponds to Z equal to zero. In the region of normal incidence, an interference between the forward and backward waves with a modulation from 0 to 0.32 is observed in the central dielectric layer of the structure. The enhancement factor of the transmitted wave in the substrate takes values of around 0.001 here. For the field of the transmitted wave in the substrate can be observed. Therefore, the maximum field enhancement for the theta equal to 7.5 degrees, the regions of high field enhancement of around 20 can be observed in the central dielectric layer. And The enhancement of the field and transmitted wave of 0.1 can be also observed. Therefore, the maximum field enhancement at theta equal to 7.5 degrees is around 100 compared to the field in the at the normal incidence case. The phase distribution of the electric field as a function of the position in the structure on z-axis and the angle of incidence is shown in figure, right figure, in the region of normal incidence. The minimum phase change is observed with increase in theta. In the region between 7 and 8 degrees, a phase jump is observed for the transmitted field here and the field inside the structure here, which is characteristic for resonance excitation of the eigenmode. In the vicinity of 7.5 degrees, the phase change is maximum. Thus, the resonance field enhancement and the rapid phase changes in the central layer and substrate are related to the excitation of the propagating modes of the asymmetric Fabry-Perot resonator. In conclusion, in this work we estimated the characteristics of the resonance line shapes in the transmission spectra of silver quartz silver structures based on the approximations by Lorentz formula. Numerical simulations of the field characteristics clearly demonstrate the excitation of the Fabry-Perot cavity modes in the structure. The approximation data suggests that the lower values of the resonance weights are achieved at higher values of thicknesses of metal layers. The higher values of the resonance height are achieved at lower values of the thicknesses of the silver layers. This implies existence of the optimal values of the thicknesses